Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start our AP NEET question on chapter atoms. Okay. So in this atoms, first we will go through the synopsis. So you can see that the atomic models. The first atomic model, it is given by Dalton. That is called Dalton atomic theory. It is in 1806. So what it says, all the chemical elements are composed of tiny particles and they are called as the atoms. So these are all the tiny particles. They are indivisible. They cannot be divided further. So I also say that the atoms of the different elements, they will form, they are combined and they form the another element. So let us consider the hydrogen atom. So hydrogen atom, one more hydrogen atom, they will combine, they will form the hydrogen molecule. So this is simply one example. Okay, the carbon plus oxygen atoms, they will combine simple ratio and they are going to form a different molecule. So this is the concept given by the Dalton. After the Dalton, so the J.J. Thomson model came into existence. So J.J. Thomson model, it is also called as Plum-Pudding model, so that you are familiar in your regular classes. Okay, so Plum-Pudding model, it explains that the electrons are embedded in a system. Here you can see here. So this is nothing but a Plum-Pudding model. Here these are the negatively charged particles, so they are called as electrons. And these plums, so these are electrons act as a plum. And this pudding, it is nothing but the positively charged. And he says that the positive charges are equally, the positive charges are accompanied by this electron, so that the atom is electrically neutral. Failures of the Thomson model is nothing but it does not explain the spectral lines of these atoms. So spectral lines that you have studied, the Lyman series, Balmer series, these are all the spectral lines. Here this Thomson model, he does not explain that, and he does not explain the large angle scattering of alpha particles. So that is you have studied in your Rutherford atomic model. Next time I am going to show that. In the Rutherford model, the alpha particle scattering, it is very very important. So what is the arrangement of this alpha scattering? So experiment, this consists of the alpha particle source. So this will be alpha particle source. Alpha particle source. Okay. From this alpha particle source, so the alpha particle source, they are emitting in all the direction in order to confine it. Adana en martare ondu lead bricks olage iddare, and they will make only one narrow opening. So this will be the narrow opening. After passing through this narrow opening, they are made to pass through this lead bricks. So these are called as lead bricks. So detail agi regular classes alli odidre. So hege pass aagbekare enagutte, they will form the narrow beam. So this will be the narrow beam. So this narrow beam, so this narrow beam, beam of alpha particle, they will meet this target. So which is the target? The target is nothing but the gold foil. Okay, see the gold foil. So after meeting this gold foil, they are scattering different direction. In order to note that, okay, elli elli adu moment agide anna detect madodakke en martare, they are going to use this zinc sulfide screen. Hege ondu screen anna ittirtare, idu namage gold agide, aim is the gold. After scattering, idrallu pass aagmele enagutte, they are moving in different direction. Adakke en martare, zinc sulfide screen anna avaru construct martare. This zinc sulfide screen en martare anta helidre, if the alpha particles are hitting this, ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ಇಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಫ್ಲಾಶಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್. ಸೊ ಲೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಿ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್? ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್, ಬಟ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ತರ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಏನಂತ, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿವಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎ ಸ್ಲಾಶ್ ಆಂಗಲ್, ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಬರ್ದಿದ್ದೀರಾ, 0.14% ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ 1 degree ಅಂತ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀರಾ, ಸೊ ಅಬೌಟ್ 1 in 8000 ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ರಿಪಲ್ಡ್ ಬಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇದನ್ನ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾಟರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರದರ್ಫೋರ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾಟರಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿ ಥಿಯರಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಇಟಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ನೋಡೋಣ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಅ ಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ against this scattering angle so scattering angle you know so what is meant by scattering angle this is the alpha particle so this will be the incident direction this is incident direction gold falling hit maadid takshana like that they are moving in this direction this angle is called as scattering angle the angle between so the graph between the scattering angle that is nothing but it's taken along this x axis and the number of alpha particles you will got the exponentially decreasing term this is exponentially decreasing term and he calculated the number of particles and gave the relation n of theta is proportional to 1 divided by sin to the power 4 theta by 2 okay so I show this is very important distance of closest approach so what is this distance of closest approach so either maximum questions are from this distance of closest approach and this impact parameter okay so in the next one let us consider this as the gold so it is a gold AU okay so here is the alpha particle so alpha particle is coming to this direction here it comes one to another some alpha particles are they are moving in this direction some are so it comes here मध्य मत रिवर्स बरते इन स्वल्प पार्टिकल बंद सो दे आर मूविंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन सम अल्फा पार्टिकल्स आर मूविंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन और सम अल्फा पार्टिकल्स आर मूविंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन हेगे बरता सो अकॉर्डिंग टू कंक्लूजन ऑफ दिस रदरफोर्ड दिस अल्फा स्कैटरिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट ओके इल्ली अल्फा पार्टिकल्स बरता इदे दे आर मूविंग मींस दे आर प्रोसेसिंग दि काइनेटिक एनर्जी ओके These alpha particles are moving with they are moving with this kinetic energy. Particles are positively charged. They are positively charged, and from the conclusion, this particle is nothing but it will be the nucleus. Nucleus also the positively charged. Okay, the alpha particles are positively charged, and the nucleus is also positively charged. So, here the positive particles will be interact with each other. It is nothing but the repulsion. So both are repulsion. So for example, so you can take the magnet. So north pole and north pole. Here, the magnet and hatra to one another. Again, if it stay force like this, open part side, they will not touch each other. That is, they are showing the repulsive force. Here also, the positively charged alpha particles and positively charged the nucleus of the gold foil. So they are repulsion. So repulsion hatra is nothing but the energy decrease like that. The kinetic energy in aagbeku it must be decrease so kinetic energy decrease aagta ide antu helidre yav decrease aagbeku according to law of conservation of energy kinetic energy goes on decreases means the potential energy it must increases so okay the energy neither be created nor be destroyed but it can be transferred from one form to another form alpha particles are moving when it comes to hit this target so target anta bartha idu idinondu alpha particle ide idinondu gold foil is stationary alpha particle is coming but as both are positively charged it will not hit here but it will be rebound so that this energy of this alpha particle decreases energy enough decrease agutha law energy adu kinetic energy kinetic energy decrease aagidare potential energy enagutho increase aagutha but one point alli next one point this alpha particle enagutte rest ki bandu matte rebound agutte ige kosta ide rest ki barutte matte rebound agutte yav point ige adu rest ki barutalva that point is called as distance of closest approach andre astu close aagi enagabodu adu hogabodu ige movement maartta idini illi hatra hogtide distance of closest approach bandidakshe enagutte matte enagutte reverse agutte ಆ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದಿ ಸೊ ಈ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ Okay, the kinetic energy of alpha particles is equal to the potential energy between these alpha particles and this nucleus. So understood. So now, what is the expression for this distance of closest approach? So at the distance of closest approach, the kinetic energy is equal to the potential energy. Okay, the kinetic energy represented as Ek. And what is the expression for potential energy? So in derivation we have written. So it is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. It is Q1, that is charge on these alpha particles, and the charge on the gold foil, that will be the Q2 divided by this distance of closest approach D. So then what is the value of Q1 and Q2? So Q1 and the other, it will be the alpha particle. So alpha particle charge is nothing but 2 times E. Hydrogen it has only one electron system. So therefore our only one proton is there. Plus 1 E. Therefore you can write it as 2E and therefore Q1 is equal to 2A. So Q2 is equal to, it will be the nucleus of gold. Q2 is equal to, I will write it as Z into E. For gold Z is equal to 79. So first we are going to write the general expression. Therefore you can write it as kinetic energy Ek is equal to, it will be 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1 is 2E, that is 2E into Q2 is ZE divided by this D and R. So now we have to distance of closest approach D value. So therefore I will write D is equal to, it is a solid point for the 2E into ZE is, it is nothing but 2ZE square divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. The kinetic energy na ikkada thagondre it will be Ek. So this is the expression for distance of closest approach. So next one, impact parameter. So what is this impact parameter? So impact parameter, so clearly, so you can see here, impact parameter is denoted by B. So idana en maadidvi B and the denote point. So impact parameters are the what? It will be perpendicular distance from the center of the target nucleus. In nucleus in a center is on the perpendicular distance on the top right. This will be the perpendicular distance. So this is called as the impact parameter. And what this indicates, the parameter A and indicate one. This parameter indicates the projection of the alpha particles. And that is S2 alpha particles from straight tag movement tag there. S2 alpha particles equal to there. S2 alpha particles will equal to bandit the value of the that value is given by the impact parameter. Okay? Parameter, it will give the projection of the scattered alpha particles. And the initial direction, yaw direction or scatter the value of the, it is given by this parameter, that is B is equal to Z square into cot of theta by 2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into A. So what are its conditions? If B is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, this perpendicular distance is equal to 0. So perpendicular distance 0, so this is the nucleus. So B is 0, the alpha particles are moving towards this nucleus, head on collision, they are bouncing back. So only potential B is equal to 0, then theta cot of theta by 2 is equal to 0. Yaw cot by 2 is 0, cot 90 is equal to 0. Theta is equal to 180 degrees, scattering angle is 180 degrees. So this angle is nothing but it will be 180 degrees. So therefore, the alpha particles are rebound back from the target nucleus. The target nucleus in the direction, the back side is scattered. But B is equal to infinity. So B is equal to infinity and the length in our before it must be increasing. So B and continuous increase. Yellow in the direction,
ಏನ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ v is equal to infinity ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಸೋ ಈಗ ಇನ್ಫಿನಿಟಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಅಂತ ಈಗ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಲೋನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ನೀನೆ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಸೋ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದೇ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದು ಇಫ್ b is equal to infinity ಸೋ b is equal to infinity then tan theta by 2 is equal to infinity this implies theta is equal to 0 degree ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ they are moving in a straight line ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ there is no angle so that is nothing but alpha particles goes undeviated from a for a large d So next one. So then, what are the limitations or the failures of this Rutherford alpha scattering, this Rutherford alpha scattering experiment? In theory classes, you are discussing very detailed. So it does not explain the account for the stability of the atoms. So stability of the atoms are not able to explain much. So one more limitation is nothing but it is unable to explain the atomic spectra. Atomic spectra na explain much. So this will be the limitations of Rutherford atomic model.